I want to bring in Dr. Shirlee Xie, Associate Director of Hospital Medicine for Hennepin Healthcare. And Doctor, thanks for being with us. I know your hospital is in downtown Minneapolis, the state of Minnesota, currently dealing with a recent spike in the number of people hospitalized with COVID-19. What has been the hardest part of your job this week?
I think it is just the feeling of just suffocating all the time. You know, we're suffocating in our patients' isolation and their fear. It's suffocating in just the emotional and physical exhaustion of all of our colleagues. It's feeling helpless because there's often nothing we can do for people. And I think it's the constant thought of what's coming next. 9,000 Minnesotans were diagnosed with coronavirus on Sunday, and then another 9,000 on Monday. And every single day, thousands more people are getting this virus. And we know that means that in a few days, in a week, hundreds of people are going to come into the hospital, and hundreds of people are going to die. And I think that sometimes when you hear statistics like that, you become numb to what those numbers mean. But for us, you know, the people that are taking care of these patients, every single number is somebody that we have to look at and say, I'm sorry, there's nothing more I can do for you. And it's just another family we have to call to tell them that their loved ones are going to die.
It's so heartbreaking. Oh, my. And clearly so overwhelming. I can feel your stress and your strength at the same time, because you're hanging on and you're still doing your job even when it seems obviously so difficult. And I wonder, you know, why do you think there's this surge? Is it, what do you attribute this?
I think that people are tired. People are tired of, you know, wearing masks. People are tired of staying in their homes. And truly, my heart breaks for everybody who has lost their jobs or their housing, and for kids that aren't able to go to school, and for people that can't see their families. But I don't think that people can really comprehend how horrific this disease is unless they've been personally touched by it. I mean, people are literally suffocating inside our hospitals, and they are dying alone. And they don't get the luxury to complain about COVID fatigue, and their families don't get the luxury to complain about it because they're living in like COVID hell. We all want to be able to have our lives go back to normal, but it doesn't mean that we can pretend that this doesn't actually exist. And I think that's the problem, is that, you know, no one wants to believe how horrible it is, and so they've just given up.
How do you keep pushing forward?
You know, I think it's just, it's hard. I think it's really challenging sometimes to not accumulate all of these experiences and have that weight. But I'm only Dr. Xie in the hospital. You know, when I leave and I go home, I'm Shirlee, and I'm mama to two amazing little kids. And they know what COVID is. They know what their parents do at work, and they've had their whole lives change already. But quite frankly, I mean, they are more concerned with, you know, complaining about what I'm going to cook for dinner than what's going on in the world. And I think it's just remembering that we have responsibility to our patients, but we also have responsibilities outside of the hospital too. And remembering that you can't change these things that have happened, but you have to keep moving forward because there is still so much more work to do.
When you talk about us not becoming numb and not be just seeing the numbers, but really seeing the bigger picture, can you tell us more about what you and your staff have been witnessing with the patients that are coming in with COVID?
Yeah. You know, when I think about what we're seeing with COVID, there's always a picture that comes to mind, and it's a photograph that was on the front page of the Star Tribune, our newspaper, a couple weeks ago. It's a picture of a man in an ICU bed, and he's lying on his stomach, and he's wearing high-flow oxygen in his nose. And it just, every time I see that picture, I think this is what COVID is. This is what we're seeing. And you can see that he's fighting to breathe, and he's fighting to live, and he is suffering. You know, COVID, it's not the cold. It's not the flu. It ravages your body. It attacks your heart. It attacks your brain. It destroys your lungs. You know, we're seeing so much suffering. I think I have had more patients die in the last 8 or 9 months than I have my entire career. I don't know how to describe that to people.
And I just don't know how you even begin to cope with that. The work you do is really, really God's work. We're so lucky, all of us as Americans, to have people like you working hard to save lives. Dr. Shirlee Xie, thank you for talking with us and sharing your experience. We're sending you and all of your colleagues strength and just tremendous gratitude.
Thank you.